It's 112 straight. The team that refuses to let this streak die.
Yeah, we're enjoying it.
The Edmonton Oilers victorious.
What they have been doing lately against anyone.
Edmonton has erupted.
It's so difficult to go on runs like that.
They've joined this 1968 Montreal Canadiens as the only Canadian-based teams to win 12 straight. Edmonton has exploded again.
It doesn't look like they plan on losing soon.
No, it doesn't. Hello, everybody, and welcome to On the Fly. I'm Jameson Coyle. What a run it's been for Chris Knobloch and the Edmonton Oilers. Since taking over the reins, the Oilers have won 22 of 28 games, catapulting themselves from the basement of the standings right up to third place in the Pacific. Saturday night, Edmonton had the chance to make NHL history, becoming the 12th team to win 13 straight games. The cherry on top, doing it against your provincial rival. I present to you the always entertaining Battle of Alberta.
The Oilers are working on that historic win streak. The Flames are playing their best hockey of the season, and so there is tremendous anticipation over this Hockey Day in Canada installment of the Battle of Alberta.
He's the wrong guy to turn it over at the offensive zone, but he comes back and pickpockets it. Breaks up the play.
Here's a Vander Kane, a pass to the middle. Down the shot at the door.
Vladar making his second only third start in a row in his National Hockey League career. He makes a huge save here. Closes the door right in tight.
Connor McDavid getting a step on Hanifin. McDavid shoots and it's Vladar once again with the answer. Pass up it. Derek Ryan's in. Moving to the net. And once again, Derek Vladar has the answer.
Different version of the Battle of Alberta between the University of Alberta and the University of Calgary.
As the Oilers come in. And
just 4 points separating these two teams in the standings. Here comes Ryan McLeod, and look, he scores!
The Oilers finally solve. Dan Vladar taking a 1-0 lead here in the Battle of Alberta.
Brings it through the legs and then elevates short side. What a move in tight.
Trying to get away from Mangiapane, his backhander. Picked up by Uyghur. The Flames at 3-on-1. Coleman, a pass over to Uyghur. He scores! Of the season in this edition of the Battle of Alberta is tied at one apiece.
Mackenzie Uyghur knocks this one down with the glove and then activates. What a beautiful, patient play by Blake Coleman.
And if it moves in, a wrister fought off by Skinner. Rebound picked up by who was just sent to the ice. To Coronado. He plays the puck ahead, catching up to it. Coronado puts it on net. Skinner looking for it.
Coronado, he just gets in there, and as he tries to throw this through, it goes off the paddle, off a stick, and kind of comes right back into Skinner.
Gets it to Dylan Holloway. Shot blocked. CeCe feeds down low. Sam Gagne out there, and it
ricochets into the net from behind the goal line. That is your go-ahead goal. A fortuitous bounce for Sam Gagne.
Off the equipment of Vladar and somehow finds its way into the back of the net off of him. And that's a tough one for Calgary. It's a bounce for Edmonton on the forecheck.
And the puck comes out. Racing to it is Zach Hyman. He gets to it. Hyman. A wraparound and he scores. That's going to do it. That's a historic 13 straight victories for the Edmonton Oilers.
The Oilers just keep on rolling. With the win over the Flames, Edmonton extends their franchise-best win streak to 13 in a row. They passed the 1967-68 Canadiens to set the longest winning streak by a Canadian team in NHL history and are just the sixth team in the last 20 years to have a win streak of 13 or more games. Staying north of the border, Saturday marks the 82nd game for Rick Tocchet as Canucks head coach. During that span, Vancouver is 50-23-8. That's a .667 points percentage, good for sixth best in the NHL during that time. The NHL leading Canucks have now won six of their last seven games, and they reached 30 wins faster than any group in franchise history. They were trying to make it 31, taking on the Leafs.
It is a special game, one of the best building atmospheres every season. Two rabid fan bases love to watch the other team lose. As for the players, they love it.
Now Hughes changing spots, put it in front. That's a puck. Hope that he scores. It's
It's a quick start for the Canucks as Hoeglander breaks the ice.
Benoit runs into Oman. Big hit on Garland to the corner by McCabe. Oman hands it off. Here's the shot. Hoeglander again.
Doubles down and it's 2-0 Vancouver.
Hoeglander just a tough angle and an absolute rocket of a shot.
And now Dakota Joshua
hits in front of the net. On the knock away, Garland scores. Connor Garland. And it's 3-0 Vancouver.
This Vancouver team, their first period has been their best. They're now plus 25, best in the National Hockey League in the first. They've been ready to start games this year and been able to get the lead. And first and second periods have been their best.
Nylander scores from distance. William Nylander bumps the slip and has goal number 199 and gets the Leafs on the board.
34 to work along with Tavares and Marner. There's Marner in front. McCabe scores.
Jake McCabe. Leafs get one and they're within one. 7:26 into the second.
Nice pass ahead. Nylander. And Nylander scores.
What a shot by William Nylander. He doubles down and the game is tied.
Well, that's one that, again, Demko's got to have. There's the little deflection that Demko thinks it's going to come right into his chest. He can't react quick enough. And a timeout by Rick Tocchet to just try to settle everything down.
Dakota Joshua dividing a screen. That was Tocchet's right
score. And the Canucks have regained the lead. The Leafs get stuck and Connor Garland doubles down. And Vancouver with a minute to go in the period. Back on top.
An opportunity here for the Vancouver power play.
Oh, here's a steal. The Marner's got a break. It's Marner to tie it. He does. Short-handed goal. It's 4-4.
Look at how deep Demko's back in his crease. He's midway through the blue there, and it's not how hard the shot is. It's the placement.
Another power play chance for the Canucks. Hughes on this side. Shooting scores.
Miller's goal, his 21st of the year, third time in the third period. Leafs are going to be shorthanded. Yarncroak and Nylander, the penalty kill. It's in front, scores!
What a pass to Patterson. It's another power play goal and a two-goal Vancouver lead. And the Canucks will win it 6-4.
Quinn Hughes just keeps putting his name in the history books. The captain picked up 3 assists in the win over the Leafs for the 7th time already this season, which ties Henrik Sedin for the most 3 assist games in a single season in Canucks franchise history. Sedin set that record in 82 games back in the 2009-10 campaign, while Hughes has matched it already in just 46 games played this season. All right, some big news out of Long Island on Saturday as the Isles fired that man, their head coach Lane Lambert, and announced Patrick Waugh as the new coach of the Islanders. For more on this story, Elliot Friedman joined the guys on NHL Tonight.
Breaking news from Long Island. Patrick Waugh, the new head coach of the Islanders. And you can see here, they started the season pretty well through the first 28 games, 14-7-7. But over these last 17, it has been a challenge, 5-8-4. And through it all, there's been a lot of games lost, overtime losses, shootout losses, blown leads. Joining us is our NHL Network insider, Elliot Friedman, to kind of take a look at this. And, Elliot, we know with Lou Lamoriello, we've both been around it a long time. This kind of comes out of nowhere because he keeps things buttoned up. What was your reaction when you heard the news?
Well, I think the first thing you hear is you're like, oh, my God. And, you know, one of the things you make sure is like, so someone sends you a note and you're thinking, OK, is this a practical joke? Is this for real? You never know. And not taking a shot of Patrick Waugh or anything like that. It's just that it's such a big shocker that you're sitting there saying, OK, I better make sure that this is correct. But there's a couple of things here. Number one, I think we kind of did realize there was the possibility of a coaching change coming. And number two, you know, Lou Lamoriello has always had a fascination with the Montreal Canadiens. And I know it generally goes back before Patrick Waugh was in his prime and was such a great player for Montreal. But anytime I hear anyone or Lou Lamoriello being interested in anything, I always make a note, like, is there a Montreal connection? The other thing, too, and I think it's important to mention there, I believe that, you know, initially when Patrick Waugh left the Avalanche, the way it happened, there were a lot of people who said he'll never get a second chance. But I think as time goes on and, you know, people, memories change, people get the opportunity to reinvent themselves a little bit. People think that Patrick Waugh is a really smart guy and really knows how to get players to play. And I'm not hugely surprised he got another shot at this. One thing I had heard, guys, was, and I'm going to check a couple teams, but I had heard he was on the radar in at least one, if not two, other situations. So I think Patrick Waugh's time was coming, and I'm not hugely surprised it was Lou Lamoriello who decided to take the jump and do it.
What does he bring to the table immediately for this New York Islander squad?
You know, Bill, I think one of the things is he makes you run through a wall. You know, like these highlights, like this is perfect Patrick Waugh. Like, well, you know, he's always looks like he's yelling or seething or something like that. And he always has had incredible confidence. Like, Bill, you played for coaches. What's one of the things you have to have? You have to have presence. You have to have control of the room. You know, Patrick Waugh, he has presence. He has control of the room. And I think that that's one of the things that he'll have. He'll grab control of the room. He'll demand they play a certain way. He'll have their attention. And the other thing is he really fires up people to play for him. They, you know, he understands what buttons to press. He has the credibility of being a Hall of Fame player. And he really knows the games. One of the things that people talk about is some coaches, they're great motivators. Some coaches know the little small things to improve people's games. He knows both.
When we come back, it was a brotherly moment in the city of brotherly love when both Nathan MacKinnon and Logan O'Connor were a goal away from the hat trick. Some wholesome content coming your way after the break. What the Flyers have done already this season is nothing short of impressive. Here we are, mid-January, 2 weeks shy of the All-Star break, and Philly sits in second place. Yes, second place, just 2 points behind the Rangers for that top spot in the Metro. Philadelphia trying to keep the good times rolling, winners of five straight games, taking on the Avalanche in our NHL Network Showcase game. A win today would be a season-high six in a row for the Fly Guys.
There's a shot, and it goes in! Deflected in front of the net, and it eludes Carter Hart, and the Avs get out to the 1-0 lead. Power play over, there's another chance, and Bracken buries it up high, and the Avalanche take a 2-0 lead.
Look at the dish by Nate MacKinnon, cross deep, and watch how Rangnick goes down and scoops this one.
Pass ahead, here's a chance for MacKinnon.
Goals in consecutive games and a beautiful assist.
Here's a chance in front, and Fairby puts it home, so the Flyers answer, and it's 3-1.
Those young hockey players like what they see. Great job along the boards. And it's Frost who draws the defender down, puts it on a pillow for Fairby.
The sticks of Travis Konecny, and it seems to be working.
Shoots this one through from distance, through a little bit of a screen, but certainly a stoppable one for Carter Hart. He knows that. Erson now getting the assignment for the third period. He'll come in replacement of Carter Hart.
Looking to move on the attack. He takes it to the front. Defensive posture there by Depatine. Staying near the net.
Oh, Tippett's down. Tippett's down and behind the play. He'll go into the boards awkwardly. There! And that could very well be both an ankle and a knee on the left side. You can see he's in a world of pain right now.
Here's a drop now. Forrester with a shot, and he scores! A rocket off the crossbar and in! So Tyson Forrester! Here's Kings. Low to high. Quick shot. And deflected. Oh! It's Atkinson at the net. And the Flyers have cut it to one.
Good job by Logan O'Connor to draw that penalty by moving his feet. The Avs get control. The car looks. Fires. Stops in front. It's loose. And it's in. And it looks like McCarr's going to get an assist on that. 300 points in his NHL career, 75 goals, 225 assists in just 280 games. Second fastest defenseman to get to 300 points. And it's only one game more than Bobby Orr needed.
It's incredible.
Look for the goalie to come out at some point soon. There he goes. 6-on-5 right now for Philly. There's Drysdale with a one-time shot.
Coming down the stretch. Drysdale with a rocket and a deflection. Jurgiev, nice butterfly. That one, the rebound with the left pad.
Under 30 seconds left in regulation. Puck cleared off the glass and out. Here comes McKinnon. Can he get the hat trick on the net? He gets it away to Logan O'Connor.
That is what hockey's all about. Nate McKinnon, I want my guy LOC to get this hatty.
His impact on this game, we see, has been
everywhere.
Multi-dynamic, dimensional in this game. Drew a penalty. Shorthanded into that 3 goals.
That's incredible stuff.
Look at the smile.
Oh, my goodness.
Face. I mean, that's something special right there.
Look, Nathan McKinnon has been on a tear for weeks, but Saturday's four-point effort against the Flyers put him in sole possession of the NHL scoring lead the first time this year and for the first time in his entire career. McKinnon, who has 77 points this season, currently has a two-point lead over Tampa Bay's Nikita Kucherov for the most in the NHL.
A heck of a way to get a Saturday night rolling. Sergei Breland on the Ring of Honor. And now we are ready for hockey. The Devils on the back half of a back-to-back against the Dallas Stars. So Count Foot heads to the box. Sets up a Dallas power play, 5:36 in.
Sent it low. Look for triangle passing. And Pavelski scores! Joe Pavelski, who leads all Stars. That is his ninth power play goal of the season. And Dallas strikes quickly. Mercer in front, and Wedgwood the save, and leaked behind him. Ben helped keep it out, and Wedgwood got just enough of that one to slow it down and keep the Devils off the board. The Stars spring it ahead for Hintz again, shorthanded, drag to the inside. He scores! A gorgeous goal! Shorthanded tally for Roope Hintz. What a move, and Dallas is up 2-0. Allows Duchesne time to catch up, fed it to the left, and back to Duchesne, slam dunk. He scores, and Dallas has their biggest lead.
This is the second goal in the game where they got the puck back again after the Devils broke it up.
Bank down. Wyatt Johnston curls, finds Hintz. He scores! A beautiful setup by Johnston. Hintz has his second of the game, and he's the first Star this season to hit 20 goals. Shot score by Smith, and that one just ate up Nico Daws. An innocent-looking shot, and not an innocent result for the Devils as the Stars hang a high five on the board here early in the third. In with more chances. Nice drag. Gorgeous move. A shot. Score! A thing of beauty from Wyatt Johnston. That goes straight to the highlight reel, and Dallas is up 6-0.
More mistakes grew, and that's why we're sitting here 6-0. Here's Brett, he scores! So the Devils finally get one past Wedgwood, and it's a 6-1 game.
You know what, those kind of...
To Foley, blasts it in! His first goal in 7 games brings the score to 6-2.
An impressive one, a dominating one for Scott Wedgwood, an all-around terrific win for the Stars, who beat the Devils 6-2.
Joe Pavelski is 39 years old, but the guy just keeps scoring goals. Pavelski's tally in Saturday's win over the Devils was the 468th of his illustrious career, tying him with Pat LaFontaine for fifth most among American-born players. The four players ahead of Pavelski have all scored at least 500 goals.
How about some daytime hockey here at Mullet Arena? It's the Coyotes hosting the Nashville Predators, battling for that wild card spot.
Coyotes are fresh off that three-game road trip. They went 1-1-1, three of a possible 6 points, and a chance to reset their game here on home ice.
The Coyotes continue to fall. They got to get back to the winning ways here tonight against a team that they're chasing in the standings.
The center ice it goes. Sean Durzi will look to move it in. Now throw to the front, a chance and a goal! Clayton Keller! He might have taken a shot up high as well. And the Coyotes with a 1-0 lead.
Well, who else? Clayton Keller. I think he's leaking a little bit. That'll hurt a little.
Took a shot up high.
A little bit less because of this play. And the Coyotes all over it. Tell me Sean Durzi's not feeling it. The spinnerama. Look at this play right here. On net. Dylan Gunther finds Keller back door, and is that beautiful? Right onto the tape. Two beauty passes.
Played it behind, and Ryan McDonald will try to move it along. Coyotes intercept. Keller scores! Second of the afternoon, Clayton Keller. He's got 19.
Good forecheck by the Coyotes all over it, forcing the Predators into a turnover. And there's the snapper, Clayton Keller.
Power play number three on the afternoon for the Predators. Mostly body saves so far, just being in the right pathway. Here's Josi off the post, rebound score! It bounced back in, and Josi will pass Shea Weber for the most goals by a defenseman in Predators history.
And that's a huge goal, not only for the record, but in this game.
Now, again, McBain to the front, they score! Michael Carcone, and it's 3-1.
What a second effort by him to put this into the back of the net and get that next goal, an important goal after the Predators cut the lead to 1.
O'Reilly wins a third draw in the 6-on-5 situation. Forsberg looking for the stick of Michaels. Follow-up shot, score! Tommy Novak cuts it to 1. Nashville winning those face-offs at the key time, and Novak was the right man in the right spot.
This puck goes wide, it gets deflected here, and then Novak right there just sneaks it in the short side as Ingram tries to get over, and he can't quite seal the post. And a big goal by the Novakian. Preds within 1.
Off the face-off, they get the win. Josi sent it towards the front. Dumba just going to try to eat it in behind the net. Poked along, Dermott, ditto, and the clock will run out. The horn sounds and the Coyotes have won it. Hard fought afternoon game at the Mullet, and Connor Ingram back into the win column. And now just 4 points back of the Nashville Predators for fourth in the Central Division.
Don't look now, but Gold Caulfield was at it again. Make that 5 in a row for him. It's an original 6 slugfest in Boston after the break.
And the Montreal Canadiens are on the power play.
Slavkovsky to Monahan. Monahan in tight. Caulfield scores! Goal! Caulfield puts it home, and it's a 5-game goal streak.
Had a goal and had the jackhammer going against Zach MacEwen. And Carlo, the net drive, scores on a gorgeous speed from Frederick.
Here comes Roy. Joshua Roy fights his way inside and finds scores! Lalania on the setup from Joshua Roy! And the Canadians restore their lead!
Assists on both Canadians' goals, and Jake DeBrus takes it right to the goal! Of the first period, Grzelcyk tees it up, high with net front deflection, and the Bruins lead 3-2.
Gets away from Stevens, down to Frederick, in tight, backhand, step on the ball, he makes the second save.
He makes it look like he's going to go towards the boards, and he kind of shifts out Stevens, and then gets it down to Frederick.
A high sticking call that'll send the Canadians to the power play. Caulfield for Suzuki, in front, Monahan with it, to Matheson, scores! Mike Matheson rips it home, his first in 12 games, and the Canadians tie it at 3.
So when he gets this puck, he doesn't have a lot of time, he knows that people are going to be converging on him. So once Heinen bites and comes to 91 Monahan, then he lays it back for Matheson to skate right into it.
To Boquist, springing Heinen on a 2-on-1, he scores! Danton Heinen's first two-goal game of the season. Pasternak through for for Coyle, and he scores!
Transition game for Boston from the defensive zone to the offensive zone.
Harvey Pinard broke it up. Gallagher again in front. Wayne, it scores! That line kept driving to the net, and Brendan Gallagher on his third chance puts it home, and the Canadians are within one. It's 5-4.
Pasternak on a partial break. Save and a score! David Pasternak has his 30th goal of the season, his fourth consecutive multi-point game. Coyle fakes the shot, takes it behind the net, and Marchand has his 20 goals, 11 consecutive seasons of 20 goals, and all-time Bruins record, 8 season high for Boston. Bruins to the power play, hiding the front man, and he has his first hat trick in his 450th NHL game.
How about those goals? They were coming fast and furious on Saturday night in Boston, with the Bruins netting 9 in the win over the Habs. It's only the 5th time in the history of the rivalry that the Bruins scored at least 9 goals against Montreal, and the first time they've done it since 1998. The Winnipeg Jets are playing so well right now, they look like the Blue Angels, just putting on a show every single night. Since December 1st, no team has played better. Winnipeg is an NHL best 17-2-2 with a plus 36 goal differential. And they did almost all of it without their superstar, Kyle Connor. Well, Connor's back and healthy again, but the most impressive thing about the Jets right now is the fact that they've allowed 3 or fewer goals in 33 straight games. The Wild, back in 2014-15, have the expansion era record, 35 in a row, but that is in serious jeopardy.
The Jets have been red hot with the best start in franchise history, looking for their 30th win of the season, and much of it has to do with the play of Connor Hellebuyck. The All-Star is 9-0-1 in his last 10 on the road, and the Jets have a league-best 2.28 goals against per game. And Sandberg will come up with it. Couldn't get it by Kubalik. Fell. Rank comes in to dig that free. Does Giroux a chance, and Hellebuyck is there to make the save. Chartier might have a chance to get a break swimming. Matthew Joseph, all alone, turns and fires. Got a shot away, and Hellebuyck the save.
Boy, Hellebuck's making it look easy right now.
Dickerin in front, and not much of a tip from Tarasenko, and it just dribbled in on Hellebuyck. Down in the corners, Toninato, a penalty coming, and a fight back in behind the play, too. Dillon didn't like the hit from Tkachuk that sent Toninato down, and so Brendan Dillon and Brady Tkachuk will throw punches. The lefts knock the bucket off the head of Tkachuk, and he wants to continue throwing, but the linesman will jump in.
An extra hit. Dillon responds.
And now send ahead, and skating onto that. Niederreiter 3-on-1, following up. Mason Appleton, the trailer on a 3-on-1, and he opens the scoring for the Jets. To the point, Stutzla, across, one-timer by Norris, rebound, Shabbat just shot it wide. And Hellebuyck scrambling, penalty about to expire. Another chance, one-timer, stopped by Hellebuyck, Stutzla a shot. And it's a shooting gallery around Connor Hellebuyck by the Senators, but he's holding the fort.
Well, Norris with a couple of good chances off the half boards, and again, Hellebuyck, when you're ahead of the pass as a goaltender, you're on your game.
Norris chasing after it, blocks the pass from Schmidt in front.
The Senators get in a hurry. Norris first, and Tarasenko with a beautiful pass finds the stick of Kelly, and the Senators a well-deserved goal.
There's words for DeMello, but a steal from Tkachuk the other way. 3-on-2. Giroux waits, fed it in front. Tkachuk the back end. Now trying to play it off on top of the goal, it goes.
Well, DeMello
with the giveaway here as he gets jammed. And what a poke check by Hellebuck to Kachuk there. That might be a game saver. And then shortly afterwards, where does this one go?
Into the boards by Zub. Norris, look out, lost it to Mesnikov, a shot, sharp angle. And Korpisalo makes the save just before the buzzer. For just the fourth time this season, the Ottawa Senators are headed to the extra time. Sets have allowed two goals or fewer in a straight game now. Nikolai Ehlers breaking in on Chikrin to the backhand, scores! Backhand from Nikolai Ehlers with 45.8 seconds left in overtime will give the Jets the 2-1 win.
The Jets are absolutely locking things down defensively this year and have now gone 14 straight games without allowing three or more goals. Winnipeg is the first team to do that since the 2013-14 Kings. Over the past 60 years, only four teams have allowed two or fewer goals in more consecutive games than the Jets.
Dahlin's a really good player. At 18 years old, now he's 23. This is his 400th game coming up here this afternoon. He's got 13 goals already this year.
Jonas Johansson, 21st start on the season, 9-6-5 on the year, .891 save percentage. His last appearance was a win against Montreal, December 31st.
Here's Cirelli with a steal, back for Hagel. Hagel dishes, they score! Nick Paul buries it from his off wing, and the Lightning strike first, 1-0.
This is one of the prettiest sequences we've seen for the Lightning all season long.
So first power play of the afternoon goes to the home team, the Buffalo Sabres, who have the puck. Dahlin gets it to Thompson. Thompson, who had 20 power play goals last season. There's a shot and a glove save made by Jonas Johansson on Benson.
We mentioned the power play has not been great for Buffalo. They are 2-for-8 in their last two games.
Try to make a move, and he's giving it up to Mott. Mott shorthanded, races away. Mott in, scores! Tyler Mott with a shorthanded goal, and it's 2-0 Tampa Bay.
Tyler Mott deserves this, and he needs this, especially when you get a shorthanded goal. This is outstanding work by him. Lukanen doesn't play this one very well. Look where he is and how much room he gives on the short side. That's a goaltender who's not showing a whole lot of confidence.
And the Lightning have a two-goal lead.
Samuelson, far side, one-timer by Dahlin, forcing the save by Johansson, and the rebound out front. Cousins scores! Dylan Cousins, the workhorse from Whitehorse, shoots and scores the Sabres to within one. 2-1 Tampa now with 6:08 to go in the second period.
And see Dylan just moving into that open ice right there. Kucherov not able to get a stick on him.
There, the Sabres step out. Clifton up the middle. Here's Tuck. He's got a breakaway. Stopped by Johansson. What a big save there by Jonas Johansson on Alex Tuck. Buffalo steps right back in. Here's Tuck. Tuck in. Shot, save, rebound. And Johansson's got that as well. And he's making some stops here in this third period to keep it to one-goal Lightning lead.
This is a heck of a save by Johansson. It's the first opportunity, but then watch him move sideways and not quit on the puck.
There goes Lukanen into the bench. Extra attacker comes on with 1:36 to go in regulation. What a chance there. Now it's DeHaan. He'll look, and he does not miss. Calvin DeHaan into the empty net, and it's 3-1 Lightning. Try to cut towards the net, not going to get there. Comes back for Power. Power hangs on, takes the shot. One more stop by Jonas Johansson. Jonas Johansson, his first start in 3 weeks.
Yeah.
And has he come up big in this third period or what? Jonas Johansson, the former Buffalo Sabre, excellent tonight in this 3-1 victory.
It's been a long time coming for Logan Couture. 45 games to be exact. The Sharks captain makes his season debut when we return.
If there's any team that could use a positive shot in the arm, it's the Sharks right now at this point in a tough year, and it's great to have Couture back.
Nabushkin and off the glass to Burrow. Down into the corner, Carpenter, and they score! Philip Zadina!
Anaheim is challenging the plate to see if it was offside prior to the goal.
We're looking at Ryan Carpenter on the right side. I do believe he is the guy.
After the coach's challenge, it was determined that the play was offside. Therefore, we have no goal.
Here's Logan Couture, his first game of the season. In front for Vlasic. They score! The captain sets up Vlasic. It's 1-0.
nothing. The crowd has gone crazy. The two old guys, so to speak, hook up. Heck of a pass by Logan Couture. He's back, baby.
Here's a turnover, and the Ducks trying to get that goal right back. And is it in?
I don't know.
So. No.
They're going to look at this to see if this puck has gone over the line. And is that puck inside? It looks like it's inside.
After review, it was determined that the puck crossed the goal line. We have a goal.
So a rather delayed congratulations to Jackson Lacombe, who has his first National Hockey League goal.
And a hurdle with it. Gets by McCann, far side. They score! Kyle Burrows, his first goal as a Shark. And it's 2-1. Nice move against Lacombe. Sederlund in.
What he does, he skates fast and he shoots the puck. There's no hesitation.
In the dying seconds of the period, and Blackwood kept it out with some help from his friends. Back in front, and Henrik scores! What a wild finish to this second period that was scoreless with 5 minutes left.
Game's still up for grabs, and the Sharks need to show they can close it out here at home. Ruda!
It's Troy Terry. Terry snaps it over, and a shot from McTavish scores!
What a shot.
What a pass by Terry. That had a lot of mustard on it, and the Ducks are back within one.
You're right about that.
He'll steer it for Nico Sturm, and that's just wide. The hurdle puts it back, and that'll do it. Tomas Hurdle puts the finishing touch on a Sharks win with 6 seconds to go. Riley Smith back in Vegas as a member of the Pittsburgh Penguins, getting a standing ovation here from the crowd at the Fortress. Out injured right now, but what a career he had, one of the original Misfits.
An emotional return even though he can't play, and well-deserved reception here and welcome back from the fans for what he's meant to this organization.
Marcisseau the other way, into the zone, pounded, and a glove save by Jari.
Best stop of the night right there from 35 and White.
What a save.
Carlson dishing over to Graves, holding it, centering, scores! Ryan Graves with a fortunate bounce, and the Penguins strike first just with 11 minutes to go in a second.
Look at Graves just anticipating rolling down the wall. He does that little leg kick, sells that shot, and then takes a couple extra steps.
Crosby again, he connects, gets Salt, scores! 20 on this season for Jake Guentzel, and the Penguins go up 2-0.
It's a movement away from the puck that creates this. Guentzel just gets lost up top.
In front of shot, Jari makes a spectacular stop on Cotter.
Here's that save by Jari. He just pushes up from down low to the slot.
Petrangelo across to Martinez. Throws it towards and attempts a rebound score! Jonathan Marchessault looking to start a comeback.
The high plays a little tip off Barbashev and Marchessault right at the top of the crease. He's going to win the battle in front, find that puck, and shovel it past the glove of Jari.
Charging down the wing, takes it in deep, and centered it! And Dorofeev scores! Pavel Dorofeev! And the Golden Knights from 2 goals down to a tie game!
Drives to the front of the net, that centering feed goes off Jari, bounces right below the hash marks, and Pavel Dorofeev past the glove of Jari, and the Golden Knights tie it at 2 here in the third.
Now Brassard score! Brendan Brassard, his first in the NHL, gives the Golden Knights the lead.
I think the smile says it all. What a moment. What a play by Barbashev. Protect the puck, recognize pressure. He sees Brassard coming in, puts it in an open area, and Brassard, the quick release.
And the Golden Knights, well, they come from behind, 3-2 win.
Jonathan Quick back in this building for the first time as an opponent.
Three-time Stanley Cup champion, twice here in Los Angeles. Best goaltender they've had.
Kempe to Mikey Anderson, saved by Quick. He got the rebound as well. Two great saves.
And Quick stopped him the first time and then was in position to get the second one. There he is, stays up high, tall, gets the glove in the right spot.
Leaves it down low. Fiala just dying, battling, more in for the puck, more spinning, centering, loose puck.
Lewis, right? Recover a puck, get it to the front, and watch this. Hold, 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 and he pushes on one skate while the other skate digs in.
Zibanejad, cross ice feed, broken up. Kings with numbers, 3-on-1. Fiala, Deneau to the net, across it comes, Moore to Deneau, and he hit the side of the net. And again, the Kings don't get a real good look.
Make sure you get the best chance you can. So Fiala has it, he tries the cross ice pass, and it's redirected to Deneau. They get something out of it, but not the best opportunity.
Kings at full strength. Rangers two shots on goal with the man advantage.
Two big pad saves by David Rittich. The first one I thought the most impressive because there was a lot of traffic in front and he found a way to understand and sense when the puck was coming.
Kempe moves it, stopped by Zibanejad with room. Fox, pass down low.
There's the Zibanejad right there, intercepts it, finds Fox, and then Fox, the Kreider, who just deflects it in to tie the game.
Picked up, moving in to the net, backhander, Anderson Dolan, save, score on the rebound, Quinton Byfield, and the Kings have regained the lead at 2-1.
But it was nice to see Jared Anderson Dolan just lower his shoulder and take the puck to the net. You get the loose pucks, and you're up 2-1.
Second power play for New York. They had two shots when Roy was in the box early in the second period.
But the Kings do dodge a bullet right off that first opportunity by the Rangers, where they had the redirection. Trocheck one way, puck the other, and there it is off the post.
12 seconds left. Panarin, one last rush in. Can't split the defense. Kings with it, clear, and that'll do it. David Rittich with some big stops late gets the win. He beats Jonathan Quick, who comes to L.A. for the first time as an opponent.
Well, it's no surprise that Kevin Fiala found the back of the net in the Kings' win over the Rangers because, well, he loves playing against New York. In his last 12 games against the Blue Shirts, Fiala has racked up 8 goals and 8 assists for a total of 16 points. Plus, 6 of those games were multi-point efforts. Time now for your top shelf plays of the night.
Drop pass, Forster, waits, fires, and scores! There's that patented shot from Forster. He buries it.
What a shot this is.
Oman hands it off.
Here's the shot. Hit right again. Doubles down, and it's 2-0 Vancouver. Goes up and over the shoulder and off the post and in the other side.
There's Malinsky. A shot, deflection, score!
From the stick to blade to the back of the net. Stars bring it ahead for Hintz again, shorthanded, drag to the inside. He scores! A gorgeous goal! Shorthanded tally for Roope Hintz.
Nikolai Ehlers breaking in on Chipper to the back. And scores! Backhand from Nikolai Ehlers with 45.8 seconds left in overtime will give the Jets the 2-1 win.
It is Hall of Fame night tonight here in St. Louis as the Blues and the fans will honor three of the very best to ever don the Blue Note. Great to see Big Walt and Mike Liut and the late Pavel Demetra's family here.
McMichael draws the penalty and here's a chance for the Caps power play.
Now the Blues to center, shorthanded. Here's Parayko in. Shoots, he scores! A shorthanded goal by Colton Parayko! And the Blues lead 1-0.
Look at this pass through the middle here. Knocks it out of the air. Right to the ice. Skates up the ice. Uses his speed. And there's that wrist shot that he's been using very effectively this year. He beats Chucky Sideburns there to the glove hand side.
Lindgren with a pad stop on Thomas, who still has a chance. Backdoor Buchnevich. Robbed by the Outlaw.
And that's athleticism, that's quickness, that's competitiveness, all in a nutshell. What a stop with the blocker sign.
And there was a penalty on that play, by the way, as Binnington goes off to Buchnevich, the fault, and then Shen shoots, he scores! Shen on a delayed penalty!
Blues captain!
Hudson puts it in the back of the net. Just a great play all around by all the guys on the ice. Jordan Binnington on the bench. They move it around. Lots of patience here. And this one right here, the captain just waiting for it, drops the hammer.
Brendan Shen gets his 10th goal of the season in 250th of his career. The Blues lead 2-0. Pacioretty gets it low, centered by Strome. Now a pass across, and what a save by Binnington! Otto Ovechkin, his best save tonight.
My gosh, Jordan Binnington goes post to post against one of the greatest goal scorers of all time. As Dowd interferes with Neighbors, back up for the power play.
Kyrou gets it to Thomas, shoots, and he scores! Might have been tipped by Neighbors, we'll save. And a power play goal makes it 3-0.
Well, Blues forward Jake Neighbors paid the price, but he gets rewarded by getting to the front of the net and deflecting a shot from up top. Robert Thomas, no hesitation. Look at the hand-eye coordination, and it drops all the way down into the net there.
And a pass, blocked by Fulk, ends up back of the goal. That's going to do it. 2 seconds left, and Jordan Binnington with his 14th career shutout on the weekend. They honor his agent and the all-time wins leader among goaltenders.
Time now for three stars of the night. Our third star of the night is Connor Garland, who had 2 goals and an assist in Vancouver's 6-4 victory over Toronto. Garland has now scored 5 goals over his last 9 contests. Your second star, Colorado forward Logan O'Connor, who netted a hat trick in Saturday's win over the Flyers. O'Connor now has 11 goals on the season, which sets a new career high for him. And your first star of the night is Boston forward Dan Heinen, who netted his first career hat trick in a blowout victory over the Canadiens. Heinen, who came to training camp on a PTO, has 8 goals this season. All right, that'll do it for this edition of On the Fly. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Jameson Coyle. We'll see you next time.
We recognize Sergei Breland's. It's time for him in the Ring of Honor.
The 1988 Boston Bruins.
A thing of beauty from Wyatt Johnston.
Best to protect the net for your LA Kings.
Jonathan Quick!
It's raining hats for Danton Heinen. First hat trick.
Backhand from Nikolai Ehlers will give the Jets the 2-1 win.